Hello learners, in this video I'm going to talk about the different kinds of shares in a company. Generally, we have two types of shares in a company. One is preference shares and the next one is equity shares. So now let's look into what are preference shares. Preference shares are those shares who have preferential rights regarding the payment of dividend and the repayment of capital during the winding up of the company. Now, the word preferential right regarding repayment of dividend means that once the company makes profit, after paying the debenture holders the interest amount, the next shareholders who are entitled to get the returns is the preference shareholders. Only after paying the preference shareholders, if there is any amount of profits left behind, then it will be distributed among the equity shareholders. Next, the word preferential right regarding repayment of capital means that generally shareholders are repaid only during the winding up of the company. So in the case of winding up of the company, for preference shareholders, they will be paid their capital immediately after the debenture holders are paid back. So after paying the debenture holders, the next people who are entitled to receive their capital is the preference shareholders. Only after paying the preference shareholders, if there is any amount left behind, it will be repaid used to pay back the equity shareholders. Next, we look into the different types of preference shares. The first type is cumulative preference shares. Cumulative preference shares are those shares where if in any year the company does not make profit, then the arrears of dividend in the year in which the company has not been made profit will be carried forward, and this arrears of dividend will be paid in the succeeding years. So supposing in the year 2020 the company has not made sufficient profits to declare the dividends, then the dividends for the year 2020 will be paid from the year 2021 onwards to, in the succeeding years, the company will arrange for the payment of the arrears of dividend. Next, non-cumulative preference shares are those shares who do not have the right or the privilege of carrying forward the arrears of dividends to the succeeding years. So these preference shareholders will be paid dividend only in the year in which they make profits. Next, participating preference shares are those shares who are holders basically who, apart from getting a fixed rate of dividend, also get to an extra share in the surplus profits of the company. On the other hand, non-participating preference shares are those who are entitled to only a fixed rate of dividend. They do not enjoy any share in the surplus profits of the company. Moving on to convertible preference shares. Convertible preference shares are those who have the option of being converted into equity shares after a fixed stipulated period. On the other hand, non-convertible preference shares are those who do not have the option of being converted into equity shares. Redeemable preference shares. Generally, shareholders are repaid back their capital only during the winding up of the company. But in the case of redeemable preference shares, these shareholders will be paid back their capital after the expiry of a stipulated or fixed period. Next, moving on to irredeemable preference shares. Irredeemable preference shares are those shares who do not have the option of being repaid back during the lifetime of the company. These shareholders will be paid back the capital only when the company is winded up. So these were the different types of preference shares. Now moving forward to the advantages of preference shares. The first advantage of preference shares is that it appeals to cautious investors. Cautious investors are those investors who are very careful in their dealings or in their investments and who do not want to assume much risk. So since preference shareholders guarantee a fixed rate of dividends, therefore they appeal to cautious investors. Next, in the case of preference shareholders, they are allowed to vote only on matters which affect their interest and not on the other matters. So therefore, another advantage of issue of preference shares by the company is it helps the company to retain the capital, since the preference shareholders consent is needed only on matters which affect them. On the other matters, they are not which do not affect their interest directly, the preference shareholders are not allowed to vote. The next advantage of preference shares is preference shares are convenient for the company because they do not create any charge on the assets of the company. Now, creating charge on the assets of the company means that when we are issuing debentures, okay, supposing a company issues 10 lakh worth debentures, then 10 lakh worth of company's assets are kept aside. Means kept aside in the sense that these assets can neither be sold nor can they be mortgaged in order to get further financial assistance from any institution. They have to be kept aside, and in the event when the company is winded up and if the company is under a loss, then in that case these assets will be sold to repay back the debenture holders. Whereas in the case of preference shares, when the company is issuing preference shares, they do not have to keep aside such assets. Okay, so the issue of preference shares does not create any charge on the assets of the company. Next, the issue of preference shares is much economical when compared to the issue of equity shares. When the company is issuing preference shares, the cost of issue of preference shares is much less compared to that of the equity shareholders. Lastly, preference shareholders pose as a good alternative for debentures. Generally, there are certain common features or characteristics between preference shares and debentures. Like in both the cases, in both these financial assets, the investors get a fixed rate of return. So, but then the advantage of investing in preference shares is that the preference shareholders get a higher rate of dividend compared to debenture holders who get a little lesser rate of interest. So these are some of the advantages of preference shares. Next, moving on to the disadvantages of preference shares. The first disadvantage of preference shares is that preference shares pose a big financial burden for the company, as the rate of dividend which is paid on preference shares is much higher compared to the rate of interest which is paid on debenture holders. Next, accumulation of dividend. In the case of cumulative preference shares, if the company does not make profits in any of the years, then the arrears of dividends will be carried forward in the succeeding years. So this leads to the problem of accumulation of dividend. Next, cost. Next disadvantage is the preference shares are costly. The issue of preference shares is much costly compared to the issue of debentures. So that is another disadvantage. And lastly, preference shareholders are not entitled to vote on all the matters. They are entitled to vote on matters only if it affects their interest directly. So these are some of the disadvantages of preference shares.